Hi, Gaylerd here. Hey, in these next few tutorials, I'm going to show you some great finger exercises that will really help you with your finger dexterity, finger control, and even timing. This is a very common exercise that all levels of guitar players use, and it's called the spider walk. Now, you're going to see that the purpose of it is to help you use your fingers independently on the fretboard. That means that you're just going to use one finger at a time. You're not playing chords, you're not playing double stops, you're not doing anything. One finger, one fret each time, okay? Now there's 1,000 different finger patterns that you can use for spider walks. As I shared with you, some are for advanced players that are trying to learn how to do scales a lot faster on the fretboard. And there's a lot of spider walk exercises that are for beginners just like you, and those are the ones we're going to focus on. We're going to focus on the beginner spider walks just so that you can start learning how to use your fingers independently. You know, I want you to think about this. The piano, when you see a piano player, he's using both his fingers on the keyboards, and they're pretty much doing the same thing. I know they're different parts on a piano, but they're both playing keys. On a guitar, you've got one hand that's working fingers and one hand that's doing the strumming, and to play wow factor guitar, you've got to be able to do them both simultaneously in a nice, consistent, smooth accent rhythm, right? Now I'm going to teach you a few different spider walk exercises. Each one will be on a separate video because each exercise will be progressively more challenging than the previous one. So make sure you start with one, spider walk exercise one, and work your way up from there. All right, let's go ahead and get started, and I'll see you in the next frame, and I'm going to show you spider walk exercise number one. Okay, in this exercise, this is a very, very basic spider walk exercise. It's almost not a spider walk because you're hitting it more than one time. But here's what I want you to do. I want you to take your index finger, and you're going to hit it on the first fret of the first string, and all I want you to do is use your pick down strokes, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then I want you to get your middle finger on the second fret of that first string and do the same thing there, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then do the same thing with your third finger, 1, 2, 3, 4, and that's on the third fret, and then your pinky comes on the fourth fret, 1, 2, 3, 4. Couple of things I want you to watch for. When you start doing finger exercises like this, a lot of times if your wrist is up here like this, you'll never get your fingers down there. You'll never get them to play. Make sure that your wrist is down below, and your thumb is probably going to, whatever's comfortable for you, your thumb goes all up and down that fretboard, and everybody places it differently. But make sure that your thumb is just in control to help you keep your wrist down low, and your hand is arched, remember the apple, and your fingers are almost in a rainbow shape, right, when they're arched like that. That way you can make sure that you get your fingertips, using the fingertips to hit those notes. Now for me, my thumb's almost covered underneath the fretboard, but you make it comfortable for you. As long as your wrist is bent, is down, when I say down, I'm down below the fretboard, okay? It can't be up like that. You'll never get your notes. And that your notes are nice and clean. Remember, you're not trying to get speed here. All we're trying to do is get clarity, nice clarity, and timing. So you may want to go ahead and download that metronome application if you haven't already done it. Download that metronome, and you can play that at some very slow beats, and just make sure that you're hitting the notes correctly. Now, let me share something with you. There is a tendency that some new guitar players, when they're trying to play notes like this, they have a tendency, they have what they call flyaway fingers. That means that their fingers fly away from the fretboard when they're trying to play strings. So like the pinky goes way out here, you know, you pluck a string and you're index finger's way up here and this finger's down. Now, I have a tendency, sometimes I'll do that. I've been playing for 50 years and it's just, I do it for show sometimes. As a beginner, don't do it. Keep your fingers close to the fretboard so that you're able to get that next note down there nice and smooth, okay? So don't use flyaway fingers. This exercise will help you if you concentrate on what you're doing. This exercise will actually help you get away from that flyaway fingers. So here's what we're going to do. First finger on the first fret, and right there by that fret is where you want to get it, right? As close as you can. And we're going to go downbeat four times. One, two, three, four. And then we're going to change, and we're going to take our... Now, my finger's away from this because I'm exaggerating for you. But your next, your index, your middle finger goes on the second fret. One, two, three, four. What comes next? You guessed it. Your ring finger, third finger on the third fret. One, two, three, four. And then the pinky on the fourth. One, two, three, four. Now, I'm not playing it in the right beat. I want you to play in a nice, consistent beat. If you want to get that metronome, turn that on, but get those beats that are going really nice. All downstrokes with the pick. And what you want to be able to do, when you change, you want to get to the point that when you change your finger, there's no lapse in time. Sometimes when you're starting off, it'll be like this. And that's okay. That's probably the way you're going to start out. What you want to be able to do is have it just like the next beat. So you got one, two, three, four. Change one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Now, once you get up there, then we're going to go down. We're going to walk down starting on the second string. So here we go. Just take that ring finger, goes down to the fourth fret on the second string. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Index finger. One, two, three, four. Now go down to the third string. Don't worry about speed. Make sure you get clarity. Now we're going to change fingers or change strings again. Not able to get it that smooth, you just keep practicing until you can do it. It'll take you some time. Two, three, four. Okay? Now, once you do that, once you go through that, and again, you may not get it all done tonight. It's going to take you some practice. Practice when you're sitting around watching TV, when your dinner's cooking, whatever you can. Just practice doing those little exercises. It'll really help the dexterity and the finger control on your fingers. And at the same time, making sure that your hand is synchronized with those fingers. Okay, now once you're able to do that, and you're able to do it with all downstrokes, here's what I want you to do next. Now you want to do it with down, up, down, up, down, up, so that you're alternating your picking from a down to an up. So you'll do it twice on each string, right? So we go one, two, three, four, down. Then we change the fingers, change strings, go down to the second string. Down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, third string. Okay, I'm not going to go through the whole thing and bore you like that, but you know what you're trying to do.
Very basic.
That's your first effort. Very basic finger picking, but it'll get you started on controlling your hand with your finger. And you want to get to the point. Don't try for speed. Get for accuracy. Even if that's your speed. Two, three, four. And I know you can do it. I've got faith in you. Hey, I've got faith in the Lord. That's where the real faith needs to be, right? Faith in Jesus. Hey, but I know you're going to be able to do this, so practice on that, and then go to Spider Walk exercise number 2.